Word of the Primarch.
Still can't get a stable comm link.
Okay, I'm going on foot. Shepard out. Garrus, take me to the last place you saw Victus. How far?
Should be pretty quick, unless we find trouble. Damn it. Look at Palavin. That blaze of orange. The big... That's where I was born.
That's rough. Still have family there?
My dad. A sister.
How bad is it?
3 million lost the first day.
How's your military holding up?
Look around. That should give you some idea.
Now you're putting up a good fight.
For now. But how long does it take before the fight's kicked out of you? If they'd only listened to your warnings about the Reapers, we might have been ready.
Hey. Hard to figure how you prepare for something like this. Back here. Shit, I hate those things. And New York is crawling with the creepy bastards? I never should have left Earth.
It's gonna be bad all over.
Leaving the fight just pisses me off.
But you're here asking Victus to do the same thing. Leave the fight to make nice in some boardroom.
This summit is the only chance we've got. None of us is beating the Reapers alone. Soldier, you okay?
Yes, sir. We'll make it.
Have you seen General Victus?
Half hour ago. Head south.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, sir.
Not sure.
Sounds right.
Hard to see a beautiful ship like that go down.
Not to mention the men serving on her.
Yeah. We should go.
They said the Primarch was headed south. No survivors. Damn it.
Crash like that, it's not surprising.
That easy.
The Batarians took the first hit when the Reapers arrived. Not much left of them. And the Krogan have never forgiven us for the Genophage.
Right. Turians sterilized them.
Solarians came up with it.
And the Krogan hate them both for it.
So they won't be joining us.
Too bad. I fought with the Krogan. They're tough sons of bitches.
Taking this Primarch from me.
Right behind you.
Moving to the compound!
Moving!
Right behind!
General Victus?
Yes?
I'm Commander Shepard of the Normandy.
Not Commander. I know who you are. I can't wait to find out what brings you out here. Vicarian, where did you go?
Heavy Reaper unit on the right flank. I believe your exact words were, get that thing the hell off my men.
Appreciate it.
General, you're needed off planet. I've come to get you.
It will take something beyond important for me to leave my men or my Turian brothers and sisters in their fight.
Fodorian was killed. You're the new Primarch.
You're needed immediately to chair a summit and represent your people in the fight against the Reapers.
I'm Primarch of Palavin. Negotiating for the Turian hierarchy?
Yes.
I've spent my whole life in the military. I'm no diplomat. I hate diplomats.
What makes you think you're not qualified?
I'm not really a by-the-book kind of guy, and I piss people off. My family's been military since the Unification War. War is my life. It's in my bones. But that kind of passion is deceptive. It can make you seem reckless when you're anything but.
War is your resume. At a time like this, we need leaders who've been through that hell.
I like that. You're right.
And honestly, uniting these races may take as much strength as facing the Reapers. You see this devastation, Primarch? Double that for Earth. I need an alliance. I need the Turian fleet.
Give me a moment to say goodbye to my men.
Without him down here, there's a good chance we lose this moon.
Without him up there, there's a good chance we lose everything.
Look at that. And they want my opinion on how to stop it? Failed CSEC officer, vigilante, and I'm their expert advisor? Think you can win this thing, Shepard?
Yeah. I don't know, Garrus, but I'm sure as hell gonna give it my best shot.
I'm damn sure nobody else can do it. For whatever it's worth, I'm with you.
Welcome aboard. Are you ready, Primarch Victus?
One thing. Commander, I appreciate your need for our fleets, but I can't spare them. Not while my world is burning. But if the pressure could be taken off Palavin...
That's a pretty tall order.
We need the Krogan. I can't see us winning this thing without them. Get them to help us, and then we can help you.
The Krogan.
Looks like your summit just got a lot more interesting.
Have been down this road before, Commander Shepard.
But Madam Counselor, let me...
I tried to smooth things over with the Salarian Dalatras. To say she's upset would be a monumental understatement.
Some of these issues are hundreds of years old. Time to let go.
Sad to say, but any effort to ally these disparate groups seems doomed to failure. And I'm sure you understand that we cannot afford to waste time with the Reapers knocking at our door. This must be my final word. I'm sorry, but the Asari will not be at your summit.
Our alliance would be stronger with the Krogan. You need them. We all do.
I wish you luck, Commander. Goodbye.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
Commander, have you retrieved the Primarch for your summit?
Yes, sir. But the Asari are staying on the sidelines.
They'll regret that. The time for unity is now.
The Salarians will be there, though.
You don't sound very optimistic.
We expect the Krogan will be joining us, too.
I see. Well, then you've got your hands full, Commander. Was there something else you needed to discuss?
Have you pieced together how the Reapers hit Earth?
It wasn't all that complicated, really. They surged through the relays and hit Arcturus Station before we knew what was happening. From there, it was a short jump to the Sol System. Earth didn't stand a chance.
Sending us to the Mars Archives was a good call.
Still doesn't make up for the fact that the Reapers nailed us to the wall. I sacrificed the entire Second Fleet to provide cover for the Third and the Fifth to retreat. Hell, I've presided over the most devastating military defeat in human history.
How do you see us winning this war, Admiral?
By making you the tip of the spear.
I'm flattered, but the Normandy's just one ship.
And a fast one. You can move quickly, hit a target, and leave before the enemy has time to react.
That's an advantage, but can it win a war?
It's the larger principle that matters. We'll never defeat the Reapers in a full frontal assault, Shepard. The battle against Sovereign 3 years ago took everything we had, and that was just one Reaper.
I haven't forgotten.
So I'll find their soft spots, avoid them where they're strong, and hit them where they're not. And when I find gaps in the armor, I'll hammer them with every soldier, ship, and bullet we've got.
Has your analysis of the Prothean device turned up anything?
The R appears to be right. It's a weapon of some sort. A big one. Beyond that, we really can't say, other than it's going to be a hell of a thing to try and build.
Do you think it's risky, building something like this when we don't even know what it does?
To be honest, the thing scares the hell out of me, but the Reapers have forced our hand. 2 centuries ago, scientists faced the same problem in the Second World War. They weren't sure what the atomic bomb might do. Some thought it could even ignite Earth's atmosphere, but they did it anyway.
Any updates on Cerberus?
There's still the wild card here. Hitting the Archives on Mars suggests they're after the same thing we are. A way to defeat the Reapers.
It didn't seem as if the elusive man was suggesting we appease them. Not like Saren did. You'd think we'd be on the same side now more than ever.
Cerberus has never played by the rules as we know them. I don't know what their agenda is, but it has nothing to do with humanity's best interests.
The elusive man talked about controlling the Reapers. He seemed to think that's how we win this.
He's wrong. Dead Reapers are how we win this.
Doesn't mean he won't try.
I saw your report on that Cerberus soldier you found on Mars. If the elusive man is good at one thing, it's finding new ways to subvert science. It's never worked for him before, and it won't now.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Commander, thank you for allowing me the use of your ship, and for going along with this plan. Garrus said he had to attend to the Normandy's weapon systems. Something about calibrations.
It sounds like Garrus. I'm sorry to say the Asari counselor won't be joining us. She thinks there's too much bad blood with the Krogan.
She may be right, but there'll be a lot more blood. Real blood, if we don't try.
When you put it that way...
The sooner we have this summit, the sooner we'll know. Is there something else I can help you with?
I understand this is a difficult time for you, Primarch, but Earth can't survive without reinforcements. Can I still count on your help?
If the Krogan help us on Palavin, then I give you my word.
How is it being the Primarch?
Not what I imagined. The battle of all time is happening on Palavin, and I'm light years away. Reading casualty reports in the millions. If I'm going to die, I want to be with my men, so there's no doubt we fought to the last soul.
I understand. Leaving Earth to save it, it's one of the hardest things I've ever done.
I'm not surprised. Garrus speaks highly of you. You never asked to be a leader, yet your people will die if you refuse. We find ourselves in similar circumstances. Let's hope the spirits grant us the strength to see it through.
How are things on Palavin?
The casualty reports are staggering. The Reapers are using our own tactics against us. Destroy the enemy with overwhelming force.
I've seen the same on Earth.
The strategist in me admires their brutality. The Turian in me knows I'm watching the destruction of 15,000 years of civilization. My civilization.
Thank you, Primarch. My thoughts are with Palavin.
And mine with Earth.
Commander, Edie just went offline.
What do you mean, offline?
I don't know. She's not responding. I can't access the AI core diagnostics. You better get down to Deck 3.
Commander, comm systems are going haywire. Whatever's happening is centered on Deck 3.
See if you can get to Edie. I'll check the AI core.
Automated systems have the fires contained. It should be safe to enter. We'll follow your lead.
Joker, what's that sound?
Fire extinguishers, Commander. Could be an electrical fire, or something.
I'm going in. Edie, talk to me.
Is there a particular topic you wish to discuss, Shepard?
Edie?
Yes.
You're in Dr. Eva's body.
Not all of me, but I have control of it. It was not a seamless transition.
A transition? You blacked out on us for a while there.
Correct. When we brought this unit on board, I began a background process to search for its information on the Prothean device. This eventually triggered a trap. A backup power source and CPU activated, and the unit attempted physical confrontation. Fortunately, I was able to gain root access and repurpose it as I saw fit. During this process, it struggled, thus the fire.
Edie, you need to alert us about incidents like this. You shouldn't have done this alone.
Bringing the crew up to speed would have been counterproductive. All attempts to help would have been limited by reaction time.
So if you're in there, are you still in the ship?
I exist primarily within the ship. For optimal control, this unit should remain within Normandy's broadcast or tight beam range.
Are you planning to take that body somewhere?
Normandy's weaponry is not suited to every combat situation. This platform could provide limited fire ground support.
You mean you could come with us?
Correct. This body could accompany you to areas the Normandy cannot reach.
Before we do that, I need you to guarantee this mech doesn't have any more surprises in it. Run whatever tests you can, then we can talk about using it in combat situations.
One moment. I am running trials. Complete. I can send you a full report if you wish. However, my first step should be restoring functionality to the Normandy to reassure the crew that all is normal.
Just don't be surprised if the crew's a little wary of your new body. It was shooting at them a little while ago.
An excellent point. I will take it to the bridge. Joker will also want to see it.
On that, we can agree.
Was that Edie who just walked by?
Yes, it was.
And Joker is going to have a field day with this.
Two of our dreadnoughts have been lost in a matter of hours.
I know, Primarch. I'm seeing the same numbers myself. They don't look good.
We have to turn this around, and fast.
Well, you can trust Shepard, sir. If anybody can get the Krogan to cooperate, it's her. She's an old friend of Erdnot Rex.
Let's just hope friendship still counts for something in this war.
I'm sure it will, sir.
Garrus, didn't waste any time getting to work, I see.
After what I've been through lately, calibrating a giant gun is a vacation. Gives me something to focus on.
We're gonna need you for more than your aim.
Oh, I'm ready for it. But I'm pretty sure we'll still need giant guns. And lots of them.
Can't argue with that.
Yeah, so is this the part where we shake hands? Wasn't sure about the protocol on reunions, or if you even still felt the same way about me. The scars are starting to fade. I remember they drove you wild. But I can go out and get all new ones if it'll help.
I haven't forgotten our time together.
Well, I've been doing some more research on human customs. I didn't want to...
That's the protocol on reunions.
The vids mentioned it might go something like that. I had hoped it would. I mean, I didn't know if...
I can't promise how things will work out. Not with this war. But I missed you, Garrus. I thought about you a lot.
Glad to know my romantic, skills made an impression. Because it's going to take more than Reapers to come between this cross-species liaison.
Speaking of which... You said you're the expert advisor on Reapers now?
It's not as impressive as it sounds. I ruffled some feathers, so they gave me a token title, along with a token task force, so I'd shut up.
How'd you manage that?
Just followed your example, Shepard. Yell loud enough, and someone will eventually come over to see what all the fuss is about. Not that they'll actually do anything about it.
Until hell shows up at their door. Then they put you in charge.
Not like the old days, is it? Rogue Spectre and C-Sec agents running and gunning outside the lines, making it up as we went along. We're actually respectable now.
Yeah. I have a feeling that respect comes with a lot of sleepless nights. I can't even count how many lives are depending on us, Garrus.
Well, when things are looking grim, and I'm pretty sure they will, just remember, we're in this together. And if it ends with both of us dying in a giant explosion taking out a Reaper, remember I took the kill shot. Something else you want to talk about?
You mentioned you still had family on Palavin.
My father is there. Sister, too.
How long's it been since you heard from them?
Long enough to be worried.
I'm sure they're okay.
That's the thing about getting old, Shepard. The platitudes get just as old. What about you? Any word from your family?
My mother's in the Alliance. Haven't heard from her since Earth got hit.
I'm sure she's okay.
I know you don't have any illusions about what we're up against, Garrus. How do you rate our chances?
I know it looks bad now, but I think we can win this, Shepard. For the first time since we met, we're not alone in the fight. It's something I learned long ago in C-Sec. An imminent and painful death has a way of motivating people. Instead of questioning your every word, whole civilizations are going to be begging you to save them.